Hello, I'm Dr. Gleicher. I'm the medical director and chief scientist here at the Center for Human Reproduction in New York City. This is a short video, and it is really a video that we are producing in response to questions about how and why human growth hormone in fertility situations may work. I'm emphasizing may work because there is really no convincing study out yet that definitely establishes human growth hormone supplementation as clinically beneficial for fertility patients, whether in inseminations or in association with IVF cycles. Yet, the utilization has obviously greatly increased in recent years, and we elsewhere are discussing that in more detail. Here, I want to concentrate today on how human growth hormone is supposedly affecting female fertility, and therefore why we would even try to use it, and what the dosaging is that we generally use. So let's start with a very basic question: why do we even use human growth hormone in women who are infertile? And the answer is that at the very early stages of follicle growth in the ovaries, right after follicles are recruited into what is called maturation, meaning women are born with all of their eggs. That's at least how it still looks at the present time. And there's constant recruitment of these very primitive follicles, which then start a journey of 2 to 3 months, sometimes even a little longer, until they reach maturity and those follicles ultimately ovulate, or I should say only a very small number amongst those follicles really ultimately ovulates, because there's a tremendous loss on this long journey. It is kind of the analog to what is happening to hundreds of thousands of sperm that start the journey after ejaculation into the vagina, and only a handful reaching the egg at the end of that journey in the distal part of the tube. So it is a selection process that starts with a lot of candidates and wiggles down to smaller and smaller numbers, both on the male as well as on the female gamete side. Even though so many follicles and the eggs in those follicles start this journey, every month only one egg ovulates. Everything else gets lost on the way. In the very early stages of this journey, called the small growing follicle stages, at that stage, there is a substance present in ovaries, which is called IGF-1. And this substance, produced by the liver, has a synergistic activity with FSH in fostering follicle growth. Interestingly, this happens at exactly the same time where androgens, male hormones, have exactly the same synergistic activity with FSH. And this is why we use androgen supplementation in certain women. And like with androgen, because this IGF-1 effect through which human growth hormone works is primarily taking place at those small growing follicle stages, these small follicles who have now the benefit of the human growth hormone supplementation and IGF effects on the follicles have this benefit at stages where those follicles are still very tiny and still need 6 to 8 weeks to reach the stage where they become available in an IVF cycle and become responsive to the fertility drugs that we give. Why is that important? It is of crucial importance because it means that if you give human growth hormone only during the IVF cycle, you're not really treating the follicles that you will be using in that IVF cycle. You're treating follicles that will become available only 2 months later, or maybe 2.5 months later, for a potential IVF cycle. You may have some minor effects from the human growth hormone that you're giving just during the IVF cycle, but the major effect you're missing out on. And unfortunately, this is what very frequently happens. A lot of IVF centers give human growth hormone only during the IVF cycle. And we here at CHR frankly never understood that. So if you are treating with human growth hormone, and if the purpose is to get more eggs, better eggs, more embryos, better embryos, and ultimately, hopefully, better pregnancy rates, remember, you really need to start supplementing at least 6 to 8 weeks before you start your IVF cycle. Now, the next rather questionable issue is how much human growth hormone is needed. And the honest answer here is nobody really knows for sure. There are no studies that would determine what's the maximum dosage, what's the best dosage. So what we here at CHR are doing, and we are using human growth hormone currently not frequently, but also not infrequently in certain patients, and we have 2 clinical trials going in different age group of patients. We are using anywhere between 3 and 6 units per day. And you may ask, if nobody knows for sure, how did you get to those numbers? And the answer is, we kind of researched the literature, and we looked at what other people have done. And this was really the range that seemed to have effectiveness with minimal side effects. And that is important because human growth hormone, besides having the side effect of affecting the pocketbook because it is very expensive, human growth hormone also has clinical side effects, specifically edema in feet and hands, and sometimes joint pains. Now, these side effects fortunately are rare, and with reduction in human growth hormone dosage, those side effects quickly go away, but they are side effects, and therefore, how much you give your patient is important. So remember, the average dosage is 3 to 6 units per day, and you really should start at least 6 to 8 weeks before you start the IVF cycle, where you hope to see the effects of that human growth hormone supplementation on your IVF cycle. Thanks for listening.